Everything needs to be put down. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so now what should we do? Someone might ask. This is the dunya is a deception. We've understood it. I'm not saying divorce yourself from the dunya. No. We need to live. I didn't say give up work totally. I said work, but from 9 to 3. Didn't I say that? And initially you work more hours. So I said work. But understand your limits. Prioritize. Know what you want. Think carefully. Don't just think material, material, material. That is what the kuffar are doing today. Every decision of theirs is based on money, money and more money. That's all. Every single decision is based on money. How many of us, our decisions are based on money? A lot. The Muslims, many Muslims now, they have become more westernized, so-called modernized. They call themselves civilized because their decisions are also based on money. When Dajjal comes, he will offer you deen or money. If you take this deen, he will kill you. If you take money, he will say you are right, you are okay. How many of us, our decisions are based on money? Think of it. We must understand. We need to have a big heart so that we can prepare our children to face the Dajjal. May Allah make our offspring from the army with Isa alayhi salam who's going to fight the Dajjal. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so what should you do? The next verse, Allah says, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Compete when it comes to what? Maghfira, mercy, forgiveness, then you must compete. Compete with the good deeds. Don't compete with this dunya that is there. This is what is going to help you now. If you compete in tawbah, in istighfar, every day, you compete in your good deeds. You are a good person. You are an asset to society. You speak nicely. You smile with the people. You don't deceive. You don't cheat. You are not jealous of people. You are a person who makes life easy for others. Inshallah, you are heading in the right direction. When you die, that will come with you in the grave. Your good deeds will bear witness for you on the day of Qiyamah. They will come and they will literally intercede on your behalf and mine. May Allah grant us the intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Your good deeds. And your bad deeds can come as a curse. Al-Qur'anu hujjatun laka aw alayk. We've heard that so many times. Qur'an will come and it will either be a proof for you or against you. We have heard the verses today. These verses will come and they will either be a proof for us or against us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tell us, these verses came to you, they were read to you. What did you do about them in return? Did you even put a scarf on your head in the case of the females? Even a scarf on the head, sometimes it's too difficult for us. Why? We might die. And who knows if Allah intends mercy, the minute we decide to put it, next day we have a heart attack and we're gone. Where are we heading? Inshallah, in the right direction. That is the maghfirah of Allah. I know people whom they might have led their lives in a very wrong way. Then they decided, we are making tawbah. They went for hajj. They never ever came back. They died there in Mina. Allah granted them that rank of martyrdom. So Allah says, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ. Compete for the forgiveness of your Rabb and compete for Jannah. How do you earn Jannah? Jannah is a commodity that you have to pay for. How do you pay for it? Every day you have 5 installments. Fajr, Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha. You pay 5 installments. So if you missed out one, something is wrong. And if you have not paid it, there is a house there that you are not paying for. You will end up in another house. That house will have no lights, no water. You might be on the streets. You've never paid for it. So we need to pay for Jannah. Something haram is to be done. When you abstain from it, you're making a payment for Jannah. Ya Allah, I really, really felt like committing the sin, but I will not do it because I want Jannah in return, Ya Allah. Now you are heading in the right direction. And I want your forgiveness, Ya Allah. Make me strong, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, I felt like causing this big problem with my husband or my wife or so on, but I won't do it for your sake. You are the one who taught us the best from amongst you is the one who is best to his or her spouse. I want to be the best and I want Jannah in return, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, I will live under these conditions which are difficult, but in return I want mercy from you, Ya Allah. This is what we need. So that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. وَجَنَّةً, and Allah described it, عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ أُعِدَّتْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah says it is such a broad garden that we will be given, broader than even the earths and the skies put together. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant each one of us Jannah, the gardens. And Allah says it has been prepared for those who believe and who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the gift of Allah. That is what we are supposed to be struggling for. And I want to end on one note. That note is, look, we all have to go. I don't want to doom everyone to say, hey, listen, you're dying. You're dying. No, I don't want to put it in that way. But let's prepare for the day we are going. No one knows when we're going. Come on. Is not the right time now. أَلَمْ يَأْنِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَن تَخْشَعَ قُلُوبُهُمْ لِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْحَقِّ. Has the time not come? Has the time not come for the believers to turn to Allah, to adopt what Allah has revealed, to adopt the correct methods? How long are we going to carry on in our sins for? These sins, how long do they help us for? 5 minutes? 10 minutes? 1 year? 5 years? Chalo, 10 years? Then where do you go? Think of it. So Allah is saying, look, think of this dunya, where it is and what is happening, and think of how many people have left it, and think to yourself, am I going to be the exception? You are not an exception. You are also going in the same way. So make friends with Allah. Make friends with Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us Jannah, inshallah. Today I tried to describe the dunya so that we know it is just a deception. Everyone moves around the circle. Everyone thinks. You know, when you see an old man about to die, old man sick in hospital, think to yourself, in a few years' time, I might be like that. Then try and sin. Let's see. If you don't have iman, you'll end up sinning. But if you have iman, just by seeing the people older than you, you will realize that, hey, I'm going there. This sin is not going to help me. I deceived this man of 5 rands. Let me take a knock, but Allah will give me Jannah in return. Let me suffer a little loss, but I'm honest, I'm straightforward. That honesty will come on the right side of the scale, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make easy for us the difficulties. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallahi bihamdi, subhanaka Allahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Allahumma salli wa sallim da'iman abadan ala habibika khayril khalqi kullihimi. Ya Allah, forgive our sins, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are so sinful. We've committed so many sins, Ya Allah, forgive us. Ya Allah, there are sins we've committed which we cannot remember, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, there are sins we've committed which we don't even know were sins, Ya Allah. Forgive us for all that, Ya Allah. That which we know, that which we don't know. All that you know, Ya Allah, forgive us, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are pleading for your mercy, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, forgive us. Make us, purify us, Ya Allah. Make us the best of people, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, purify us, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, save us from petty dispute, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, make us happy in our homes, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, make us from amongst those who can be the true followers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Allah, create a barrier between us and Shaitan, Ya Allah. Keep Shaitan away from us, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, don't allow him to turn us away, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, help us recognize you, Ya Allah. Help us find you, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, help us love you, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, help us love you, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you to love us as well, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, guide us in every move we make, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we need you more than we need anything else, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we need you more than we need food and drink and air, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we need you, Ya Allah. The day you take us away, Ya Allah, take us away with a smile, Ya Allah. Take us away with a kalima, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant us Jannah in the Akhirah, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant us intercession of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant us the companionship of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Akhirah, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, all those who are ill, cure them, Ya Allah. All those who are sick, Ya Allah, cure them, Ya Allah. Grant them shifa kamil ajil, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, those who have passed away into your mercy, Ya Allah, have mercy on them, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, grant them maghfirah, Ya Allah. Grant them forgiveness, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, resurrect us all on the day of Qiyamah with the Muslimin, Ya Allah. With the Anbiya alayhim wassalatu wassalam, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you on this day that all those who are looking after those who are sick, Ya Allah, grant them a full reward of looking after those who are sick, Ya Allah. Those who visit the ill, Ya Allah, grant them the reward and make us from amongst those who can go and visit the ill, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, those who help solve problems, Ya Allah, have mercy on them and grant them upliftment, Ya Allah. Those who have marital problems, help them solve their problems, Ya Allah. Those who do not have offspring, Ya Allah, grant them offspring, Ya Allah. And those who do have offspring, make their offspring the coolness of their eyes, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask you all the goodness Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has asked you. And we seek protection from all the evil he has sought protection from. Antal musta'an alayka al-balaghu wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyil 'azhim. Subhana rabbika rabbil 'izzati 'amma yasifun wa salamun 'alal mursalin. Alhamdulillahi rabbil 'alamin.